hands together. Good, thumbs resting against the chest. Find your tall spine. Inhale through the nose. And exhale. Deep breath in. And breath out. We're inhaling. And exhaling. Now breathe in to tune in. Namo Guru Dev Namo. Namo Guru Dev Namo. Exhaling, relax your hands to your knees, palms up, pointer finger meets thumb tip, Gyan Mudra, eyes closed, focus up and into the brow. Inhale, thinking, Sat, exhale, thinking, Nam, meditate. Sat Nam means true self, the truth within you. And exhale. So we slow down the breath so we can slow down the body, slow down the mind. Our brain kind of wants to keep going at that high pace where we're thinking of three different things at the same time. But when we focus on the breath and listen to the breath and slow it down purposefully, we can slow down everything else too. All right, let's take this moment to get out of our head and into our body. We're going to start with stomach circles. Hold your knees, move your navel around counterclockwise. Inhale, thinking, Sat, exhale, thinking, Nam. Churn your stomach. That's it. Aid your digestion. Massage your digestive organs as you take that navel and circle it around your knees. Each circle is a full inhale and a full exhale. Each inhale and exhale is Sat, Nam. So focusing on all those things at the same time. Good, now stop and go the other way. Still circling, still lifting the lower spine in each direction. Now come back to center. Inhale, tall spine. Exhale, let it go. Turn your palms up. Again, Gyan Mudra, meditate. Long spine, long neck, long deep breath. Inhale, Sat, exhale, Nam. A deeper breath, letting go, opening our eyes, moving our hands. Listen, come on up to hands and knees. Let's keep going. Cat cow. Inhale, head up. Exhale, head down. When the head's up, the belly's down. When the head pulls down, the belly pulls up. They move in opposition to each other. Close your eyes. Keep your gaze focused at the space between the brows. Inhale, think sun. Exhale, think now. This is so good for your spine. So simple, but so good. Continue cat and cow, but see if you can pick up the pace just a little bit. Feel your spine, feel your back muscles. Now finish with your head up, tailbone lifted, belly hanging. Inhale. Hold the breath, squeeze in and up. Stay here, exhale. Hold the breath out, squeeze up again. And let it go. Take a deeper breath. Come sitting cross-legged. We're going to do some twisting. Still warming up that spine. Fingers on the front, thumbs over the back, elbows wide. Inhale, left, exhale, right, twist. On each inhale, sit. On each exhale, now move at your own pace, the pace that your breath sets for you. Imagine that your spine is long and straight, like a steel rod, and that as you're twisting, you're keeping your rib cage lifted off your hip bone. Open up that whole front area, chest, abdomen, shoulders. Keep everything nice and open. Focus to the brow. Good. Keep going. Yes, you're opening up microscopic spaces between your vertebrae, but you're also opening up spaces in your energy spine, your energetic channels. Center now, inhale. Hold the breath, contract the pelvic floor, be still, be empty. Exhale, release, meditate. Back to Gyan Mudra, meditate. Now inhale and exhale. A little bit more to do. Rest your hands on your knees. Find that tall spine, that steel rod of a spine. Without moving your head, without moving your body, just inhale, shrug both shoulders up. Exhale, let them drop. Sniff in, sniff out. Breathe in, breathe out. Inhale, sut. Exhale, now. You can make it short and sweet. We don't have to drag it out. You have to work for the first part because you're lifting your shoulders away from gravity. But that second part, let gravity do the work for you. Just let your shoulders drop. You don't really have to control it. Just let go. Sat Nam. Sat Nam. few more. Last time. Good. Let them relax. Take a deeper breath. Let it go. One shoulder at a time now. We're going to bring the shoulder up and roll it back. Other shoulder, bring it up and roll it back. Up and behind. Almost like you're trying to do the backstroke, right? If you were adding arms to this, they would go backward like that. We're just doing it with our shoulder. One shoulder at a time, moving up and back. Loosening things up to prepare for our set that removes body blocks, removes energy blocks. Good, now let your shoulders rest completely. You have an option now to circle your head around or to draw a circle with your nose in the air, and you can make it very small if you're watching your neck. All right, you know what you need to watch out for. Take a deep breath. Either begin to draw a circle counterclockwise with your nose, or drop your chin to your chest and roll your head to the left, to the back, to the right, and chin to chest. Take your time. Whatever you're doing, take your time. Opening up, stretching muscles that we just used. Giving our neck muscles a little stretch. Massaging the blood vessels in the neck. Good, now finish this way and go the other way. Now finish, let your chin roll down to your chest. Take a deep breath. Open your eyes, look at the floor, squeeze the pelvic floor, hold the breath, and let it go. We have one more warm-up. Hands and knees, we're doing camel pose warm-up. Camel pose warm-up, which is a pose in itself. Cushion behind you so you don't have to sit all the way down on your heels for the down part. You could straddle your cushion, or you could put your cushion right here in front of you and bow to it. That if your cushion helps you in any way, just use it. Hands interlaced behind us. Inhale, lift the arms off the chest, open the chest, upward, 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 eyes open. Inhale, sut. Exhale, noun, sit back on your heels, drop your forehead toward the earth, and lift your hands away from the backside. Just that slow. Inhale on the way up, eyes open, think sut. Exhale on the way down, eyes closed, think noun. Again, we're thinking of letting the whole front of the body get a good stretch. Across the chest and shoulders, abdomen, rib cage, everything. Hip flexors. We're stretching the front of our hip as we open up the back, leaning back. Last one. Let your hands come down. Stretch them out a moment for child's pose. Give yourself a nice little stretch. Breathe. And come on up and over. Lie on your back. You get a moment to rest. You finish the warm-ups. Just let everything go. Now bring yourself up to sit, and we'll get started on set, removing body blocks. A kriya is a poetic progression. It's one exercise or a series of exercises put in a certain order to help us get a certain response. It's been handed down intact for time eternal. A body block represents tension. It could be physical or energetic or both, but a body block represents tension. These first couple exercises of the shoulders and the neck hold a lot of tension. We know that, right? We feel that. This says old anger can be stored in the shoulders. So we're opening the shoulders up. Let your whole body move with each motion. Make sure you're not holding anything. So as you're doing these exercises, just think of letting go. Any tightness, let it go. All right. So the first one is simply drawing a circle with our arms. If shoulder is an issue and we can't keep them up here, then just bring them down here. But it's palm facing palm, fingertips stretching up, either here or here. Pretend there's a clock in front of you. Look at that clock. We're going clockwise. So if here's the clock, the 12, the 6, look at your own little clock and figure out what clockwise is. Now put that clock on the sky and figure out 12 to 6 and back to 12. Which way is clockwise? That's the way we're going. All right, hands up and start going what you think is clockwise. Your arms are taking that circle. Your fingers are painting that circle on the sky. And the more comfortable you get with it, perhaps the bigger you can make it. Because we want to engage the whole body, not just the hands, not just the arms, not just the shoulders, but everything, all the way down to your sitting bones. Close your eyes. Focus up at the brow. As you're going around, you're inhaling sat. You're exhaling now, drawing a big circle on the sky. You can almost put yourself on autopilot once you get going. You don't have to think too much about what you're doing. It just keeps going. Just a little more. Now, sit where you are with your arms tall. Stay right there. But turn your palms to face front. We're going to bow toward the earth. Inhale here. Exhale, hands to the earth. And let your forehead move as if it could touch the floor or touch the earth. If it can, that's fine. If it's not, that's okay too. If you want to put your cushion in front and bow to your cushion, you can do that. It's just inhale on the up. Exhale on the bow. Inhale, you can open your eyes. Exhale, close your eyes. Bowing to or toward the earth. Connect to Sat and Nam. Whenever we bring our head toward the earth or bring our head down lower than our heart, know that energy is moving to the lowest part of you. So if it's moving toward your head, it's moving towards your pituitary gland, your pineal gland, more activity in the brain, or it's setting the brain up to be in a good place for the rest of the class. Last time. Good, now just come sitting. Bring your hands to your hips. Sit up nice and tall. Take a deep breath and let it go. One more deep breath and let it go. That's right. All right, next one. Downward facing dog. Come on over to hands and knees. Sit back on your heels. And when you're ready, tuck your toes and raise your hips. Adjust your hands shoulder width apart. Let your feet be a little bit apart. Bend one knee, inhale, bend the other knee, exhale. Think of your tailbone be the perfect apex of a triangle, right? Here's your chance to do this inversion without much issue. Inversion, your head is lower than your heart. The blood that usually has to work hard with the pumping of your heart to make it to your extremities, now it's getting an assist from gravity, so your circulation is much less work for your heart in this position. It's very easy. So take some deep breaths and enjoy. We're going to do one more exercise while we're in down dog. Bend both knees and lift both heels. Inhale, straighten your knees and lift your hips. Exhale, drop your heels toward the earth. Bend both knees and lift both heels. Inhale, raise your tailbone up, up, up. Exhale, let your heels drop, drop, drop. Bending our knees, we're inhaling and lifting the hips. Exhaling, straight legs, we're dropping the heels. One last time. Now settle into your down dog. Take a few breaths here. Good. Hands and knees. Hands and knees, child's pose. Sit back. Take a few deep breaths. Your thumbs. Bring our forward bend. Feet about hip width. Inhale, raise your hands up, fingertips to the sky. Exhale, folding forward, close your eyes. Inhale, eyes open on the way up. Exhale, eyes closed on the way down. Inhale into sut. Exhale, nam. The upward motion as a preparation for the downward motion. If you can fingertips reach to the sky, and if you can go back a little bit more, then challenge yourself to do what you can do. Good, now come up to stand. Inhale, arms wide to the sky. Exhale, prayer pose to the heart. One more, sweep your arms up, inhale. Exhale, close your eyes, focus to the brow. Thumbs resting on the chest, meditate, prayer pose. Thank you.
give each leg a shake. The next one is higher impact. I'm going to choose the low impact option, but it's going to be hands on hips, feet apart, feet cross, feet apart, feet cross. So just apart together, just jumping, however you can manage that. The easier way out with no impact would be feet apart, feet cross, feet apart, feet cross. So just stepping instead of jumping. So high impact or low impact, it's up to you what you want to do. It's only a minute. So ready or not, here we go. Apart and cross, apart and cross. I'm glad some of us are giving it the whole thing. Good for you. Yeah, there you go. Don't forget to breathe.
Italian dance. Sorry, Scottish.
Scottish dance. Getting the, that's all right. That's all right. I'm thinking before COVID hit, I was visiting my daughter, and she put the kids in the daycare room. She and I went to the Y out in Albany, and we did a Zumba class. I mean, I used to teach Zumba. And by the half hour mark, I'm like, aren't we done? It's like, my body does not like high impact anymore. Not at all. All right. Very good. Last two. Last one. Good. Shake your arms. Give yourself a deep breath. Let it go. Next one, feet and arms. High impact would look like this. Right? But low impact is the same thing. We're just adding arms. Doesn't matter which cross is on top or on bottom. Doesn't matter. Hold on, let me get a timer going. Ready? Here we go. Jump apart and cross. Apart and cross. That's it. You know, on the weirdness factor, this doesn't even rate, right?
I know, right?
Consider it other things we've done. Hey, if somebody can get rid of my tension by telling me to do this for a minute, I'm all there.
Yeah, right.
All there.
Yeah.
It's true.
Yeah.
No way. It sounded like a buzzsaw, chainsaw. Almost there. I know, it's a very long minute. Last one. All right, relax. Step your feet apart. Inhale through your nose. Exhale through your mouth. Inhale, nose. Exhale, mouth. One more time. Good, now shake your arms. Take a few easy breaths. Shake a leg. Shake a leg. Stay right there. We are moving on. Oh, yeah. Come have a seat on your cushion. Okay, make fists with your hands. Make your forearms kind of parallel to the earth. And instead of good posture, drop your shoulders, round your back in poor posture. Close your eyes. Focus up and into the brow. Just take a few breaths here. Try to let those upper back muscles relax. Let the gravity pull your arms down and your shoulders open up a little bit. All right, lift your face. Opposite of the warm-up. I'm going to keep the hands here. Just a gentle fist. It doesn't have to be really tight. We're going to lift this shoulder up and forward. Lift this shoulder up and forward. Focus on the shoulder itself. So it's coming up and around, coming up and around. And it really does mimic poor posture. So we did the reverse in the warm-up, and now we're bringing that shoulder forward. Just finding every which way we can to loosen up that shoulder girdle area. Shoulder is a very complex joint. It's got bones that are just kind of floating there that are barely tethered down by their tendons. And
and the way it fits together is quite miraculous. So there's lots of little nooks and crannies in the shoulder where we can store stress, where we can hold tension. And the shoulders sit above the lungs. The lungs are where we store grief. And if you're feeling grief, you're feeling every emotion under the rainbow. You know, it's just a big stirred up soup of all the emotions you can imagine. So we're giving them the heave-ho, trying to reach down and loosen up things that need to be loosened up. Good, now sit up tall. Place your hands on your hips, long spine, long neck. Relax your shoulders down. Long, deep breathing here. Inhale, sat. Exhale, nam. Now take a deeper breath, lie down on your back. You know what time it is, stretch pose. So if you want to aid your back, you could slide your hands palms down under your tailbone. Take a deep breath, exhale, raise your head 6 inches, raise your heel 6 inches, long, deep breathing, no breath of fire, long, deep breathing. Eyes are open, looking at our toes. One way to modify would be to do one leg at a time, let one foot rest, and then let the other foot rest. Long, deep breath. Inhale through the nose, and exhale through the nose. Take a deep breath and let it all go. Bring your hands out from under you. Roll your head a little bit side to side. Let that relax your neck. And then just rest for a moment. Okay, rock and roll on your spine. If you can hold over or under your bent knees and roll up and back, if that doesn't work for you, you could hold your knees and roll side to side. Just take your time rocking on your spine. Good, now come on up to sitting. This one's interesting. You can sit cross-legged, half lotus, or full lotus, and we're going to do some more bowing. So cross-legged is here if it helps you to sit on your cushion, or if it helps your cushion to be for your head to bow to, that's all good. Half lotus would be if you could take one foot outer edge and bring it into that hip crease, and the other one isn't going to make it, so just tuck it under. If you have such open hips that you could take your other foot and bring it up into your hip crease, you go ahead and do that. So lots of options, cross-legged, but please be careful of yourself. We all know our own limitations, don't overdo. Hands on your legs, inhale tall, exhale, we're bowing toward the earth. You don't have to touch your forehead to the earth. You can if you want to. Inhale on the way up, exhale on the way down. Inhale, thinking sat. Exhale, thinking nam. Take your time. Good. Now inhale, sit up. And let it go. And stick your feet out in front and give your legs a little shake. Relax your knees. We're going into down dog again. Down dog. So you find your down dog. But this time, pretend that you're an animal in the forest. You're walking on all fours. And try to move arms or legs, one or the other. Just pick up one foot and then the other. Or pick up one hand and then the other. You don't have to do them at the same time. Just see if you can move your limbs, move your body. So instead of holding that stiff down dog that's a straight line from your tailbone through your heels, you can loosen up that line a little bit. Same thing with your head, your neck, your shoulders, your spine. Just let it undulate a little bit. So it's a very kind of lazy, open down dog. Forget to breathe. Take a deep breath and come to hands and knees. Sit back on child's pose. Take another deep breath. Roll over on your back. Lie on your back. Parallel bicycle or push-pull. So hands could be beside you, palms down, or hands could be under you. The heels are about 12 inches off the earth. It's inhale, bring your left knee in. Exhale, bring your right knee in. Your head is resting. Let's go. Inhale and exhale. You're switching your feet, pulling one in, pushing the other one out. So your shins are parallel to the earth. A little bit more. You can do this. Ten seconds. Good. Now rest your feet to the earth. Stretch your legs out long on your mat. Stretch your arms up overhead into the grass. Inhale, stretch. Exhale and rest. Rest for a moment. We're going to stay on our back for the next one. It's an oldie but a goodie. It's the silent clap. You're going to raise your arms, fingertips wanting to touch the sky, hands shoulder width apart, arms straight up. We inhale here and exhale as we bring our hands almost to a clap, but they don't touch. So it's inhale apart, exhale together, inhale apart, exhale together. But there's always a little bit of space between your hands. Eyes are closed, focus to the brow. Here we go. Breathe in, out, in, out, in, out. Your lower body is doing nothing, but your arms are trying to clap. Your hands are trying to clap, but you're stopping them from reaching each other. And it's moving so quickly that it's breath of fire. In, out, in, out, in, out. Sniff in, sniff out. Quick, quick, quick. You're moving energy. stop. Make fists. Pretend someone is holding your fists so you can't bring them into your chest. Struggle and get mad. Take deep breath in. Hold the breath. Now struggle to bring your fist to your chest. Work it, work it, work it. Finally, you win. Exhale, hands to chest. All right, fist to the sky. Inhale. Hold the breath and pull inward. Work, work, work. And let it go. One more. Hands to the sky. Inhale. Hold the breath and pull. Pull. And exhale. Good. Move your fingers. Shake your hands. Take a few breaths. For the next one, we're going to lie on our back, and we're going to sing.
Mantra.
Hold on, let me just bring it to you for just a moment. Rest, you're doing great, you're doing great. If you can hear this. Saying Guru Guru Wahe Guru. Guru Ram Das Guru. All right, so we're going to sing that ourselves. I'll belt it out. You can listen or you could sing with me. It says, relax on your back for a few minutes and sing any mantra. So, it goes like this. Guru, Guru, Wahe Guru, Guru Ram Das Guru, 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 Wahe Guru, Guru Ram Das. Let it go. Now, as if this were final relaxation, I want you to relax everything. The back of the head, the back of the neck. Let the shoulders melt into the earth. Let the arms soften. Let your back soften. Feel supported by Mother Earth. Hips relaxed, legs relaxed, tension leaves the feet through the tips of the toes. Let yourself completely relax. Now take a deeper breath, rub the palms of your hands, the soles of your feet. Now let your legs rest and do circles with your wrist. Circle your wrist one way, and then circle it the other way. Good, now straighten out your right leg on the earth. Bend your left knee in toward your chest. Opposite hand to knee, right hand to left knee, pull it across the body, spine twist, calf stretch. Try to keep both shoulders on the ground. Don't let your shoulders lift. The hips are rotating, but the shoulders are resting. Take some deep breaths. Good. Now switch. Spine twist the other leg. Spine stretch. Shoulders are on the earth. Good. Now roll to one side, help yourself to come up to sitting and all the way up to standing. This is one of the few kriyas where we have the final relaxation before the last exercise. So we're putting an exercise after final relaxation. So it doesn't matter which foot you're standing on. You want to stand on the mat, you want to stand on the grass. Find a focal point. We're going to do a little bit of tree pose. So a couple things you could do with tree pose. We're going to have our hands here. You could just rest your ankle, heel against your ankle like a kickstand. You could lift your foot up to rest on your leg while you're balancing. You could take that foot and cross it over and balance that way. That's also a modified tree pose. Or you could take that foot and bring it right up into your inner thigh. So whatever tree pose you want to do, if you fall out, just come right back into it. We're going to do long, deep breathing. So find a foot you want to stand on. Let the other knee turn out. Now figure out if you're going to do tree pose with both feet on the earth or trying to lift that one foot. Inhale. Exhale, prayer pose. Good. Now find a spot to focus on. Find your focal point. Good. Now you could let your hands stay here, prayer pose, or you could let them reach up. Whatever we're doing, we want to stay with whatever tree pose we've chosen. We want to stay there for a little bit. This is balancing your hips and balancing the energy in the pelvis. Good. Let it come down. Shake it off. Other foot. So focal point probably is the most important thing here. Just figure out what you're focusing on. Inhale and exhale.
exhale, hands can stay in at your chest or they could reach for the sky. Exhale, come on down to sitting on your cushion. Good work. You're supposed to give yourself your own little body massage. It reminds me of EFT. EFT, what's it say? It has to do with the tapping, that you tap on certain points and release things. Emotional freedom technique, that's what it stands for. By emotional freedom technique, you're tapping on certain spots that relate to certain organs. Mm-hmm. They have you tapping on the same spot as what the meridian would be for acupuncture. So if you've ever had acupuncture, they can do acupuncture from your knee down, from your elbow down, and get every single thing in your body. They don't have to have that body part available because there's different energy channels. All right, so take your fingertips and just lightly, how about just two fingers? Tap lightly on your forehead. Lightly, lightly, lightly. Come down and tap on your cheekbones. Just a feather weight here, little finger weight, nothing dramatic. Good, now come on down. Let have one tap in the chin, that little space between your lower lip and your chin. Tap there. Good, now tap the jaw. Good, now bring four fingers up and tap your head. Tap, tap the top. Gently, gently, gently. Little tap, tap, tap with the fingertips all over your head, your skull. Interesting. Now go to the back of the head. Tap the back of your skull with four fingers. Good. Now come down to your shoulders. All right, relax. We're going to take one hand. You can either have an open palm or just a little fist to tap that shoulder. So either open palm or a little fist, whatever feels good. We're coming across, trying to get the back of the shoulder, the back of the neck. Good, now raise that arm a little, slap your armpit. There's lots of blood flow in there. Now you can give your tricep a little tap, back of the arm, and come down the side of your body. All right, other side. You can open palm or little fist, just tap that shoulder. Back of the shoulder, the upper back, right around that shoulder and chest. Good, now armpit, lift that arm. Good, now get the underside of the arm. And now down the body. Good, now take one hand, four fingertips, tap the sternum, the breastbone. I wish I remembered what these centers relate to, because it's all about emotional releasing when you're doing that technique. Now, both fingertips, collarbones. Be gentle, little collarbones here. This relates to organs, but it also relates to emotions. Good. Now, stretch your legs out in front of you and pound your thighs. Little gentle pounding. Any place where it feels tender, just stay there. And outer thighs. All right. Last exercise. Sit in easy pose. Hold halfway between your knees and ankles and spine flex. Lift your chest and roll back. Try not to let your head drop. Try to keep your head forward. Inhale, sat, exhale, nam. Now, interestingly enough, we usually do this one of the first exercises in our class, but today it's the very last one. And I think it's interesting, to me anyway, it feels different. When I do it first thing in the class, I notice how stiff it feels, how stiff I am. But now, I'm doing it at the end of class,
isn't so bad. Breathe in, breathe out. Good. Now inhale and let it go. Shake your arms, shake your hands. Very last thing. Place one hand on top of your head. Bless yourself. Take your time. Bless yourself. And let it go. We'll rub our hands together and finish as we always do. Inhale. Hold the breath. See yourself living your life healthy, happy, and fulfilled. And let it go. Inhale. Suspend the breath. Send healing energy to someone who needs it. And let it go. Inhale. Suspend the breath. Send healing energy to the planet and everyone on it. And let it go. We'll finish the long sat and a brief nam. Inhale. Sat Nam. Thank you. God bless you, Sat Nam.